Good afternoon. My name is Dave Asprey, and I'm the Associate Dean for Medical Education and Professional Programs and Professor and Chair of the Department of Physician Assistant Studies in the Carver College of Medicine. It gives me great pleasure to welcome each of you to our commencement ceremony for the class of 2020. We are delighted that you're able to join us in recognizing and honoring our graduates and celebrating the many accomplishments of the class of 2020. As is clear to each of you at this point, this celebration is not in the format that we would have desired for it to be. The virtual format has been adopted in order to help keep participants safe and to help mitigate the spread of the pandemic. Nevertheless, this does not diminish the pride and excitement that we have for each of the graduates of the class. I also want you to express my appreciation to this class for their willingness to roll with the punches that 2020 has thrown out at you. None of us could have imagined the challenges that the pandemic would pose for you over the last 8 months. Yet you have more than risen to the challenge of navigating this uncharted journey. This is an important ceremony, one that allows us to reflect back on the road that our graduates have traveled in order to complete the training program, and also to look forward to the careers that lie ahead of them and the thousands of patients that they will impact during the course of their careers. As you will hear from the comments provided during the ceremony, this is no small feat. In fact, it's a truly remarkable accomplishment that relatively few people are able to achieve. Our students are selected from an outstanding national pool of candidates. We know that they have made many, many sacrifices along the way in order to be selected by our program. They have taken the more demanding courses as part of their undergraduate degrees. They sought out work opportunities in healthcare, and in addition, they volunteered any spare time they had left over. They've made sacrifices of time, delayed gratification, and pushed themselves very hard to achieve at a high level in order to be competitive for our program. Getting admitted to the University of Iowa PA program is not easy. It's a very competitive process, and as a result, we had the good fortune to enroll truly remarkable individuals like the graduates this afternoon. Once admitted to the program, the demands become even greater. We have required them to put in a tremendous deal of effort, studying to acquire the knowledge and skills necessary to become great clinicians. These efforts have required them to continue to make great sacrifices of their energy, sleep, finances, relationships, and personal comfort during the last 2.5 years. It is not an easy or comfortable journey. Rather, it is one that is demanding, strenuous, and often stressful, and at the same time, very rewarding and life-changing. We believe that the practice of medicine as a PA is a great privilege and one that each graduate has earned through completing our program. They clearly are extraordinary individuals who will be great clinicians. This afternoon, the PA students will be receiving their program certificate of completion and the Master's of Physician Assistant Studies degree. Graduates, I want you to know that the PA program faculty and staff join your families and friends in sharing the excitement and enormous sense of pride as we join in celebrating this great milestone with you. We are extremely proud of each one of you, and we're honored to call you our very own. I would next like to introduce the faculty and staff of the PA program to you. First, Anthony Brenneman, Professor and Program Director. Teresa Hegeman, Professor and Director of Clinical Evaluation. Carol Gorney, Professor and Director of Clinical Education. Katie Iverson, Assistant Professor in the Department of PA Studies. George Burgess, Medical Director and Professor in the Department of Family Medicine. Thomas O'Shea, Director of Administrative and Student Services. Maria Meller, Coordinator of Clinical Program Services. Kayla Fairchild, Program Administrative Assistant. Geraldine Westerkamp, Coordinator of Clinical Outreach and Development. These 9 amazing individuals go to great lengths each day to help train and prepare the best PAs in the world. And now it is my pleasure to introduce Dr. Pat Winokur, the Executive Dean of the Roy J. and Lucille A. Carver College of Medicine. Dr. Winokur has served as the Executive Dean of the Carver College of Medicine since 2015, as well as Professor of Internal Medicine and Infectious Diseases. Dr. Winokur completed a residency in internal medicine and a fellowship in infectious diseases at the University of Iowa, followed by a postdoctoral training at the National Institute of Health. In 1993, she joined the faculty at Iowa, where she has been an active clinician, educator, and researcher. In the course of her career, she has been a primary author or co-author of many papers and other publications, and has been honored with several prestigious awards, and has consistently received ongoing NIH-funded research support. With a strong and diverse background of leadership in academic medicine, Dr. Winokur brings an abiding commitment to each of the college's missions in their position of executive dean. In all of her various leadership roles, Dr. Winokur has expertly integrated Carver College of Medicine resources and serves as our primary research liaison with the larger university. Under Dr. Winokur's leadership and in close partnership with Dr. Brooks Jackson, Vice President for Medical Affairs and the Dean of the Carver College of Medicine, we continue to advance in biomedical discovery, educational innovation, and superb clinical services. But perhaps of greatest importance to this audience is her unwavering support of the PA program and PAs in general. Please help me in welcoming Dr. Winokur.
So thanks, Dave. That was a really nice summary of the hard work that our students have put in. But I do want to welcome you today. This is a very wonderful occasion where we're celebrating the 2020 class of physician assistant students here in the Carver College of Medicine. And as Dave said, usually this is an in-person event, but sometimes there's a little bit of good things and change, and we're happy that some of the people that might not have been able to normally join us are joining via live stream and able to see some of their maybe grandchildren or other loved ones graduating. We are so proud to have had these students over the past 2.5 years. As you well know, this is the PA program that is ranked number 1 in the country. There is nothing else in the Carver College of Medicine that has that type of ranking, and it is a well-deserved honor. Dave highlighted the faculty that have been committed to this, but they have created a very innovative curriculum and a rigorous curriculum. The students start on day 1 working side by side in lectures with the medical students. It's a great way for them to immerse themselves in a lot of medical knowledge very quickly, but it also starts building that teamwork approach that we think is so important for medical care today. Once they get out onto the wards, that commitment to team-based care remains. They're working with the nurses, the physical therapists, all sorts of other healthcare providers. I think in the end, our curriculum has created students that are exceptional medical decision makers, and that's based on a profound fundamental knowledge of medical physiology, medications, other things that they've been acquiring over these 2.5 years. 2020 certainly has been a crazy year. It has been a year where the students have learned things about personal protective equipment that they might never have learned before. Some of them have personally sacrificed, and we appreciate their willingness to learn in different ways in different environments. I know it comes with a little bit of sacrifice and some of the camaraderie that you get being in a large classroom and joking around side by side, but I think they have done a remarkable job. One of the things that I actually think it has done, which is different, is first of all, it is absolutely critical how many healthcare providers we need in this country. And these graduates are going to be joining a medical care contingent that greatly needs their services. And I certainly think they've learned that in 2020. I also think they've learned a new lesson in empathy. As you unfortunately know, as we've gone through this pandemic, we have had to limit some of the family members that come to sit with our patients. Our students have stepped up to the plate and have become that support service for the patients. That's a lesson none of us could have anticipated, but probably will stick with them for the rest of their lives. Today marks a culmination of a lot of that hard work. They're joining a profession, as I said, that greatly needs them. As you know, we have a need for healthcare providers all around the country, oftentimes in very underserved areas like rural Iowa. Our students are some of the people that are stepping foot into those areas to provide healthcare. It's a remarkable need, and we're happy to be able to provide some of the best students in the country. The opportunity that these students has is enormous. These students come out very well trained, and some of them are gonna join professions that are very specialized. Maybe they're gonna work in bone marrow transplant. Others are gonna be in that really needed area of primary care. But all of them are going to be a part of that linchpin of healthcare that we need around this country. They'll be joining about 1,000 other PA graduates from the Carver College of Medicine. These have been remarkably successful PA practitioners around the country. We expect these students to be just as good and create that next generation of physician assistants that really set our medical care forward. We hope that they continue to connect with us over the time. They could perhaps take some of our students in their practices and help teach them just as they've been taught over the past few years. We hope that they come back. Maybe they'll give a lecture for us. But in any case, we are going to watch the remarkable success of their careers. So we're happy to have this day of honoring them, and thank you for joining us, and enjoy the rest of the ceremony. It's the students, and you'll learn a lot about them, and I think you'll see how special they are.
Thank you, Dr. Winokur, for being with us today and for sharing your remarks with us. I know that our soon-to-be graduates are proud to be an alumni of our outstanding institution and a member of the PA profession. Before I share a few remarks, I would like to take a moment to acknowledge the many spouses, partners, parents, family members, and friends who are here with us today. We wish that you were here in person to celebrate the amazing achievements of your graduates, but are thankful that we can at least connect virtually. Without you, your support, your guidance, your willingness to take that late night phone call and to sacrifice time together the past 2.5 years, many of our graduates would not have been able to accomplish all that we are celebrating here today. You should be very proud of them, just as we are, and take great pride in their outstanding achievement. It is an achievement and a level of success that few individuals are awarded. We are truly delighted that you can join us today in the celebration. For those of you that may just be learning about our program, let me give you a bit of background about the program and the profession. The University of Iowa Carver College of Medicine was an early adopter of the PA model. The profession initially developed when returning servicemen, or medics, were coming back from serving in Vietnam. These individuals had a wealth of medical knowledge and skills, but were unable to utilize these skills outside of the armed services. At the same time, there was a projected shortage of healthcare providers. This opportunity formed the basis of the PA model in 1967, when 4 medics graduated from the first PA program. The University of Iowa PA program graduated its first class from the College of Medicine in 1974.
many of whom went on to blaze the trail for your graduates today. As you've heard, graduates of our program have gone on to provide outstanding care to local communities, run their own clinics, lead outstanding PA programs across the nation, succeed as presidents of PA organizations, and rise through the ranks of academia. Today, PAs can be found in all areas of medicine throughout the United States, practicing medicine alongside their physician colleagues. What makes the University of Iowa PA program unique is its integration with the medical school. As you've heard, while many schools may take a course or two with medical students or other health professionals, since 2014, the University of Iowa PA students have taken 100% of their classroom learning alongside and are held to the same standards as the medical students. The class before you is the fifth class to graduate in this new curriculum. And like classes before them, they grasped every opportunity as it presented itself. As I learned more about them over the 28 months they were with us, I appreciated their willingness to help guide the ongoing development of the curriculum and to shoulder the unknown with grace and strength. They make me proud every day, and I know that they will continue long into the future. I should have guessed at their strength by reading their bios they provided before entering in August of 2018. The life experiences they brought with them were far-reaching, from master's degrees in epidemiology to degrees in theater arts, gerontology, religion, chemical engineering, and neurobiology, in addition to the training in biology, chemistry, and physiology. They have been world travelers and workers around the globe to far-reaching places such as Bolivia, Peru, Australia, Ghana, Central America, and the Philippines. They have worked as medical technologists, nursing assistants, in cancer research, blood bank, as a firefighter, swim instructor, and a zip line tour guide. They have been D1 athletes, soccer players, salsa dancers, and engineers. They share their homes with dogs and cats, got married, had children, and found time for occasional breaks in their hectic schedules. When it came time to transition to PA school, some had families to care for, some moved loved ones, and some came without connections to the area, but quickly found them here at the University of Iowa. As these individuals arrived, I truly saw their potential. As each brought their strengths and their weaknesses, they learned to rely on each other to help through the tough times. That is what has been a hallmark of our classes of incoming students and graduating seniors: their desire to help, to be part of that larger team, and to see the bigger reward at the end of the lane rather than each step and where it is placed to get to the end point. And now to the graduates. Wow. What can I say? It's been one unexpected, unanticipated, frustrating, infuriating, surprising, exciting, amazing year and years. I know that every one of you wondered whether we would be here today, and even if we would ever be here. You likely asked whether all the struggles, the late nights, the forcing of one more piece of factoid into your brain was going to pay off or not. I usually remind you at this point about orientation day, how we discussed that this program was like a roller coaster ride with steep climbs, fear-inducing drops, hairpin turns, and loops that you could experience in many different ways. Back then, we encouraged you to get settled into the ride with your hands in the air, eyes wide open, and take in everything possible along the ride. Little did anyone anticipate the significant G-forces, twists, flips, and turns that 2020 would provide. Each of you started this program with strength and enthusiasm. The rate at which the courses and knowledge came at you shook people to their core. I watched as each of you dug down into reservoirs you didn't know you had to pull you through this time. We encouraged you to reach out to each other and support one another, because this is what medicine is all about, learning to care for another while caring for yourself. Recognizing that you may not have all the answers, but that you can turn to another colleague, admit you need help, and accept the support. Or to reach out to a classmate and offer that help when you saw they were struggling. Each of you found new rhythms in your daily life. You learned new insights about yourself, about science, about medicine, the need to be social and supportive, and more importantly, to recognize that you sometimes need help in achieving great things. This growth, more than anything else in our program, to me is the most impressive and awe-inspiring event that occurs on our journey to becoming a PA. I hope that each of you clings to that throughout your career. Continue listening to others, leaning on each other, learning from new experiences and people. Doing so will make you better providers, will renew your interest in medicine daily, and will allow you to provide unbelievably compassionate care to all of your patients. I do not doubt that all of you carry that commitment and compassion inside of you. 2020 moved you even further than you thought possible. I know it did for me. We continue to hear of the compassionate care that frontline workers are making daily through this pandemic. We see the fatigue and burden that each carry with them. And then they come back the next day and repeat again and again because of the commitment each person brings for their fellow human beings. The faculty and I saw your desire and want to get back out to the clinics in those early days. Unfortunately, we were sidelined due to not having enough PPE for everyone. I know that all of you would have headed back out as soon as we had identified resources because you had committed to providing care, no matter the cost you might bear due to COVID. It is who we are as care providers, as scientists, and compassionate human beings. We desire to connect, apply scientific knowledge, and aid in healing all who are vulnerable. Isolating in your apartment, house, or wherever pushed many of you past points you never dreamed you would find yourself. You again found new reservoirs and identified new coping methods that will serve you well as you enter the healthcare field. I was equally amazed by and admired our faculty, who built 2 semesters worth of new courses in less than 2 weeks. Their strength of duty, desire to keep all of you on track to graduate as close to on time as possible, and still provide you the foundation of medical sciences needed to practice medicine was outstanding. During this time, each of you faced significant changes in learning formats that you had not anticipated. Again, you stepped up and took it on. While we all recognized that this wasn't how we wanted to do this, I was impressed with your perseverance and understanding. Lean on these experiences as you move into your career. Remember them as you get frustrated with how your day went. Remember them when a patient refuses to comply with your recommendations or when a colleague disagrees with you. You have built new strengths, new coping methods, and they will serve you beyond anything we could have taught you in these areas. Having seen you navigate this year, I do not doubt that you will all be outstanding healthcare providers. I look forward to formally welcoming you into the profession as a graduate of our program and to see where your journey takes you into the future. You're joining a great career, a great group of colleagues, and a life-fulfilling occupation. And while all of this is true, I genuinely believe the best part of being a PA is having the privilege of working with and impacting the lives of other human beings, your patients. That is a profound honor and privilege, and it will provide foundational meaning to your work on a daily, patient-by-patient basis. I hope you will embrace that honor and strive to become the best PA you can be. Today, it is an honor for me to welcome you into our profession as colleagues. Congratulations. I would now like to invite Terry Hayes to the podium. Terry has been identified by his classmates as their representative and will provide us with an address today.
Oh, there you guys are. Cool. All right, before I get started, I'd like to just share an experience with you guys that I had this afternoon. So I hadn't seen my daughter in over a week. And the first thing she said when she got out of the car to see me was, "Congratulations, Daddy, you're a superstar." And I'd like to share that with you guys because you guys are all superstars and we made it. So here we are. Good afternoon, class of 2020, faculty and staff, family, friends, and well-wishers. I welcome you all to a Carver College of Medicine First, the University of Iowa PA program class of 2020 virtual commencement. I share in everyone's disappointment in this not being how any of us envisioned celebrating our greatest professional achievement. With that being said, my hope is that you are still able to recognize the magnitude of this accomplishment. It deserves to be celebrated. I consider it such an honor and a true joy to have the opportunity to speak to everyone on behalf of the class of 2020. I would first like to thank our faculty and staff for giving us an opportunity. You each have said from the beginning that no mistakes were made in us being here. Although I'm sure Tom had second thoughts as he sent out several emails regarding the missing spoons in the kitchenette. Or Katie, as she told us for the 20th time, not to worry about what is now known as the infamous class of 2020 Memorial Summer Final Exam. Sorry, Katie. Through it all, your faith in us never wavered. And even in the most difficult of circumstances, you encouraged us with Baby Yoda memes and remained committed to us reaching this point. So thank you. To our family and friends, I think I can speak for all of us when I say that we would not be here today if it were not for your love and support. You deserve the loudest round of virtual applause imaginable. There aren't enough ways to show you our gratitude. Although I'm sure that you all will now become the benefactors of free medical advice. Just don't ask us about the Krebs cycle. Fellow classmates, 28 months ago, we came together as a group of strangers and a set of statistics. We were GPA, patient care hours, shadowing, and volunteer hours. However, once we started, we knew that none of those things mattered. We quickly learned that we would need to lean on each other throughout this difficult journey. And we decided that no matter what, all of us were going to reach the finish line. And each of us brought something unique to the program that allowed us to do that. You all had a profound impact in my life. I found that this is a top-ranked program, not only for its education, but also for the quality of people that it admits and graduates. I would like to share with the virtual audience some of the things that I personally have learned about each of you since you are not able to be with us today and meet each of my classmates. James is the person who is never afraid to be himself and the person who isn't afraid to speak his mind and stand up for what he believes in. Katie is probably the most professional and someone who isn't afraid to tell it how it is and simultaneously be encouraging. Molly is the person that when life gives her lemons, she just builds a lemonade stand with an endless supply of lemonade. Joseph is a patient listener and someone who will give you certified reviews of the entire Star Wars series. Jacob is the person who loves to see others succeed. And apparently, if you ask Miles, the guy who spends way too much time on his hair. Maria is the most contagiously energetic person that I've met. Alex is probably the most organized and apparently bold enough to plan and execute said plan of getting married during PA school. Joe is the hardest worker and a fellow Cyclone, first place. Justin is the most generous and always willing to host. And in the age of Zoom, the guy that refuses to turn his camera on for anyone, never change. Jamie is probably the most determined and the most prepared and the most technologically challenged I found. Adam is the guy who never sees the glass as half empty or half full, but the guy who just gets more water. Lindsay is probably the most chill person and just goes with the flow. Nick is the most focused and the most confident. Anjali is the quietest, but someone who can make you laugh when you least expect it and most need it. Kara is the best test-taking buddy and the lover of dance and Christmas decorations and cookies. Carly is the person whose presence and smile can brighten anyone's day. Sarah is the person who can make any situation better with a smile and homemade snacks. Amalia is that person who tries to make everyone feel welcome. Laura is the most composed and the calmest. And Stephanie is the most passionate, especially about waffle-flavored chicken nuggets in the Philadelphia 76ers. Lena has the biggest smile, is the most creative, and also bold enough to plan and execute the plan of getting married during PA school. Reed is the most relatable, seemingly capable of sparking up a conversation with anyone about anything. And Carly is the strongest, capable of surviving PA school and a husband being deployed. Miles is the funniest, apparently capable of living incapable of living off of energy drinks. And if you ask Jacob, the guy who spends way too much time on his hair. If I had the time, I would spend the entirety of my speech talking about each of you and the impact that you've made on my life and memories that we share. However, I would also like to leave you with some advice as we head out into the real world. As I try to think about what this day means, what I want each of us to think about each time we think of this day or that we see our diplomas on the wall, it's this, so that we are capable of even more than we can imagine. Think back to the day that you received your acceptance. I, along with many of you, did not believe that it was real, that it could be possible. Our first day of orientation, sitting in 2189, I thought they must have emailed the wrong Terry Hayes. I questioned if I belonged. Class, we made it to this point because we dared to dream. Think of everything that we have accomplished in a few short years here. We survived biochemistry with Dr. Rubenstein. We survived all of those histology slides. We survived masks, 1, 2, and 3. We completed the remaining of our clinical training during a pandemic. While not ideal, it has prepared us for some of the most challenging times that we may face as a medical professional. The journey has been far from simple, but simple is not what we signed up for. We have been pushed to the limit, and each time we have proved that we do, in fact, belong. Not because we got perfect scores or made the correct diagnosis, but because we had the courage to keep going. We have undergone a remarkable transformation, one that started with us barely knowing how to perform basic physical exam skills, to one that ends with us knowing how to diagnose and treat complex pathologies. So think back to all that you accomplished in your short time here, and think ahead to all the things that we will accomplish, and realize you are capable of more than you can imagine. Celebrate this journey, but even as we celebrate, let us remember why we are here. We did not go into medicine for power or prestige, but for the joy of serving others. So remember that while you are capable of more than you can imagine, you are also capable of doing more for others than you can imagine. Think back to your feelings of when you cared for your first patient, the sick family member in a time of need, an immigrant with no insurance whose child was sick, a coding patient on a house call. Those patients, those people, are why you chose medicine, to serve, regardless of wealth, insurance status, race, or gender. You are now capable of doing more for them than you could have imagined. Now, I do not stand here telling you that times ahead will be easy, because they won't be. If this year has proven anything, it's that we will encounter many obstacles and frustrations in our career. We have and will continue to make mistakes. There will come a day in the future where you will have those same intrusive thoughts back at the beginning of this journey that you did at the beginning of this journey. Those thoughts of not belonging or biting off more than we can chew. But even on the most difficult days of your career, remember your why, and remember that your mission is worth it. And remember that you are capable of more than you can imagine. You are capable of shining bright in a dark room. We enter the healthcare world at a time where competent and compassionate providers are needed now more than ever. Your impact will be vast. What a privilege we have to be able to serve our community in times of great need. I cannot overstate the impact that you all have had on my life. And I have no doubt that your patients will feel the same. So today marks the end of a journey that began well before joining this program, but it also is the start of a new one. We now become members of a valued healthcare team. Our colleagues will depend on us, and perhaps more importantly, our patients will depend on us. But today we celebrate. Today, we celebrate the family and friends that have supported us from the beginning and have given us the strength to chase after our goals. Today, we celebrate our commitment to medicine and to a career of lifelong learning. And today, we celebrate 25 strangers that came together to learn a craft. And today, we celebrate 25 brothers and sisters who leave as physician assistants to make their mark upon the world. Congratulations, guys. Thank you.
Thank you, Terry. Our commencement speaker today is Professor Katie Iverson. Professor Iverson has been identified by the members of the class of 2020 to provide the graduates with a charge this afternoon. Professor Iverson is a clinical assistant professor in the Department of Physician Assistant Studies and Services, as well as faculty co-director of the Bulwer Learning Community. Katie received her BS in science education from the University of Iowa and returned to Iowa in 2002 to complete her master's in physician assistant studies. She also completed a teaching fellowship in 2004 through the department. Professor Iverson has worked in emergency medicine at the University of Iowa Healthcare, as well as the Virginia K. Gay Hospital in Vinton, Iowa. She's an associate editor, medical editor for Hippo Education, where she designs and manages content for their online board review and continuing education platforms. Katie and her husband, Bill, are huge Hawkeye fans. Just ask her. She's a proud son, a parent of a son, Lucas, and two stepchildren, Gabby and Niall. If she could, Katie would own a droid or two, a baby Yoda, and is always working on using the Force for good. I'm pleased to welcome Professor Iverson to the podium with a heartfelt Go Hawks.
Well, my PA lovelies, you have all made it. It wasn't always guaranteed, because remember that summer OSCE from 2019, which almost did all of you in and almost did all of us in. Many of my gray hairs have the origin from that unnecessary yet hilarious stress. And what a very 2020 way of us to finish this adventure together over Zoom. I know I always say I miss your faces, but today that missing feels like an ache. I wish I was looking at all of you right now, just not a few on the screen as I deliver my speech. I pride myself in how many folks I can make cry, and now I'll never know. But let's let all this sink in just for a little bit. You have made it here to graduation day. Collectively, you've made it through 2,200 hours in the anatomy lab, 1,500 exams, 50 CAP papers, 225 wellness passport submissions, 250 reflection papers, 475 CBL learning issues, and 250 patient-based assessments. You've collectively logged 23,561 patient encounters, 22,876 procedures, and 31,204 diagnoses during your clinical year. You have worked in 83 different clinical sites all over the country with 245 different preceptors. Collectively, COVID took 250 weeks away from your clinical year. You are the only class to have completed 2, 3, 4, 5, or 6 week rotations. And you have completed at least 7,329 individual evaluations. And I'm sure that number is actually low. Just reading off all these numbers is super exhausting, and you guys did all that. I know all the things you're feeling today because I felt them too while I was wearing my cap and gown, though when I graduated, Zoom hadn't even been invented yet. I know you're relieved and proud and so freaking happy to be done. I know you feel unsure and apprehensive and frankly terrified that the next patient you touch will be an actual real one that you're getting paid to take care of. I know that you don't feel ready. And I know that you feel sad as you say goodbye to classmates who have become family and realize that life will take you in many different directions. But I'm here today to tell you that you are ready. You are ready for this diploma and you are ready for your first job. You are ready for patients to look to you for healing and hope. I know you are ready because I've watched you change and grow into amazing healthcare providers. 855 days ago, the class of 2020 began orientation. 855 days ago, a high five was about the only medical exam I would let you perform on me. 855 days ago, we were just trying to learn your names and figure out which Carly was which, and hoping that we could call one Joseph Joe just to make our lives easier. And now, 855 days later, after literally giving your blood, sweat, and tears, you have become PAs who will be entrusted with the care of our loved ones. It is a well-deserved and hard-fought-for honor. We here at the Carver College of Medicine and the PA program collectively have taught you a lot. We have taught you clinical skills and communication skills, biochemical pathways and disease processes, and hard to pronounce drug names and all their side effects, and how to read an x-ray, and how to write and code a patient note, and how to draw the brachial plexus. I know you will take a little bit of each of us when you go, but I'm hoping you take a lot more of Teresa's EBCP knowledge than Dave's bad dad jokes. But really, it is what you've built in yourselves over these last 855 days that makes you ready. All the sacrifice and dedication and drive to keep going. And what you have built in each other over the last 855 days makes you ready. The camaraderie to do hard things together, the way you made strangers into family, and the ways you have leaned on each other and learned from each other. Our greatest hope as the PA program is that what you have learned here goes far beyond the mechanics of medicine, that is the pursuit of healing and the sharing of life and all of its strength and fragility, and with each other and those you serve, that will be the lesson that we imprinted most strongly on your hearts and minds. It wouldn't be a commencement speech without some words of wisdom as to inspire you as you leave us and join the throngs of Iowa-trained PAs out there making the world better one patient at a time. So here goes, hashtag wise words from Katie. Be that 100% provider. Every patient you see deserves your very best care and attention. When you walk out of an exam room or out of the OR, be able to confidently say, I gave that my 100%. Now, some people will say, give it 110%, but that's like having 12 out of 10 pain on the pain scale. And we all know how I feel about that impossibility. Remember, it's okay to say you don't know. No one expects you to know everything. It's okay to ask for help, which is why we work on a collaborative team. And it's okay to look things up, because that's why Al Gore, you know, invented the internet after all. There will be long days and inboxes full of charts, but never cut corners on care. Some days you won't want to give 100%, days that you are tired or stressed or frustrated. On those days, remind yourself why you are doing this job. If you forget, ask the ones who love you best to remind you why. And if they don't remember, call me and I will remind you. One of my reasons why relates to a small charm I have on my stethoscope and on my name tag that says RJ for Ryan Johnson, who was in the class of 2016, but tragically died before graduation. His smile would light up the room, and he had such a heart to listen and serve others. When I worked overnights and had just gotten woken up for what I deemed a non-emergent reason to be in the emergency room in the middle of the night, I would see that charm and remember Ryan and his smile and his heart and tell myself to give this next patient my best smile and my best care and 100% of my attention, no matter how tired or frustrated I was, just like Ryan would if he was still with us. You don't know everything, but you guys do know a lot. And I want to tell you that you're smarter than you think you are. So my second piece of advice is to trust your gut. If something doesn't add up, ask more questions. Call a colleague, ask someone else to lay eyes on your patient. If you've got a suspicion that something's wrong, it most likely is. Advice I received early on in my career when questioning whether I should order an ultrasound for something I had remotely on my differential, but was worried just enough about. My supervising doc said, if worrying about this will keep you up at night, then just order it so you will know, because your gut is probably right. So listen to your gut and trust it. Run the test, even if you have to stay late or think you're bothering the tech at shift change. There is enough worry about our patients' knowns. Don't add unknowns to it because you ignored your gut. This advice also holds true for the days your gut says, I need cupcakes. So do what it says and feed it cupcakes. Okay, now that we're talking about cupcakes, remember to treat yourself. You've worked hard to become a PA, and you will give so much of yourself every day to your patients. Use your vacation days, even if you just have a staycation. Take time to do the things you enjoy. It's a must for your sanity. Yes, your patients will love you and need you. And yes, your clinic staff will love you, and they will jokingly tell you the place would fall apart if you weren't there, but that's actually not true. So use your vacation days. Call in sick when you're sick, because nobody wants your germs. You can only give your best when you're at your best. So take time to recharge, take time off, and don't feel guilty about it. This, my friend, is what those 225 wellness passport submissions have prepared you for. So don't you dare screw up your wellness. Lastly, I will leave you with some words from my favorite 10-year-old. No, not my son Lucas, because he's 11. And though he's my favorite overall kid, he lacks in the wise words department, though he knows a lot of Star Wars trivia. When asked to pick an inspirational quote in fourth grade, my friend Mimi picked this one. There is no elevator to success. You have to take the stairs. And explained it this way. I chose this quote because I believe it means you have to work hard to have success. Not everything in life is going to be easy. It's a good quote for me because sometimes I have trouble with things, but I persevere and I don't give up because in the end I have great results. You all did this. You took the stairs, lots and lots and lots of freaking hard stairs. And you had trouble and you persevered and you didn't give up and you ended here with great results. I am so deeply thankful to have be able to walk alongside you for these 855 amazingly hard and wonderful days. It has been a great blessing in my life. Every success, every tear, every hug before COVID, every elbow bump since COVID has left an indelible mark. Thank you for sharing yourself with me and this program for the last 855 days. To all your family and friends watching, thank you for lending us your most beloved. We know the sacrifices you have all made as they pursued this dream. We return them to you now, much smarter, more exhausted, perhaps a little bit more gray hair and lots more miles on their car. Okay, class of 2020, here come my final words. You guys are more than ready and you're gonna do great. My dad says never to speak in absolutes, so here goes. Always give 100%. Always remember the reason you became a PA. Always trust your gut. Always take care of yourself. Always take the stairs. Always remember I'm in your corner cheering you on. I miss you so much already and I'm desperately sad we are not together today to celebrate you and all your accomplishments. The class of 2020 will never be forgotten, not only because what you have survived, but because how you all have thrived in the midst of it. My pride in you knows no bounds. Y'all are my favorites, but shh, don't tell anyone.
Thank you, Katie. With us today are 25 PA students completing their Master's of Physician Assistant Service Studies degree. This afternoon, they celebrate the culmination of 28 months of intense educational experiences associated with being trained to practice medicine as a physician assistant. And we are celebrating the culmination of that hard work. At this time, we would like to recognize the students receiving PA program awards. As I call your name as a recipient of an award, your Zoom screen will be opened so that your family and others may see you. The first is the Dennis R. Oliver Foundation's PA Award. This award was established by the class of 1998 in honor of Dennis R. Oliver in appreciation for his commitment to the PA profession. For nearly 30 years, he taught biochemistry to first-year students. The award is given to a PA student based on demonstrated academic excellence in the basic sciences. This year's recipient is Nicholas Dean Jensen. The next scholarship is the Rex Montgomery PA Scholarship. This endowed scholarship was established by Rex Montgomery. Dr. Montgomery served as the original director of the University of Iowa PA program and held the position of Associate Dean of Research in the Carver College of Medicine and Interim Vice President of Research for the university. This award is given to a physician assistant student who shows promise as a PA. This year's recipient is Terry Lamont Hayes, Jr. The Dennis R. Oliver PA Scholarship. This scholarship has been endowed on behalf of Dennis R. Oliver, past professor and director of the PA program. Dr. Oliver lived by very high personal standards and encouraged the same integrity in those around him. He touched many lives, both on the academic and professional level. This year's recipient is Jamie Elizabeth Hageman. The Daniel R. and Karen Struve Colmorgan PA Scholarship. This endowed scholarship was established by Dan and Karen Struve Colmorgan. Karen Colmorgan is a University of Iowa PA program graduate of the class of 1989. Dan Colmorgan is a 1990 graduate of the University of Iowa College of Medicine. They established this award to support a student in the University of Iowa PA program. This year, we were fortunate to have three recipients. The first is Molly K. Bender. Next is Catherine M. Brown. And Alexandra Goteau Kuhn. The Dennis R. Oliver PA Student Recognition Award. Named after the former director of the PA program, this award honors those senior PA students who have contributed significantly to their class and the program by their persona, examples, and deeds. These students have left an undeniable and indelible mark on fellow members of the class and others associated with the program. Recipients of the award are nominated by their fellow PA classmates and selected by the faculty. This year we have four recipients. First, Molly K. Bender. Maria Charlotte Davis Hostetler. Carly Marie Kish. And Sarah Klotfelter Lee. The Marty Holmes PA Memorial Award. This award recognizes a PA student that exemplifies the qualities and attitudes that were held and embraced by Marty Holmes, a 1980 graduate of the University of Iowa PA program. As a student, Marty radiated confidence and good humor. As an optimist, he enjoyed life and never lost sight of those less fortunate than he. As a person of inquiry, he questioned everything and would not accept vague or unsupported responses to scientific questions. He was analytical and objective, and yet compassionate and non-judgmental. He loved life and strived to live life to the fullest. He passed away in July of 1996. This year's recipient is James Warner Ballard. I have the distinct honor this afternoon of giving out the Pi Alpha Awards. Pi Alpha is the National Physician Assistant Honor Society organized for the promotion and recognition of PA students, graduates, and colleagues. The Pi Alpha Honor Society was organized in 2004 by the Association of Physician Assistant Programs, now the Physician Assistant Education Association, for the promotion and recognition of significant academic achievement, leadership, research, community and professional service, and the encouragement of a high standard of character and conduct among PA students, graduates, and colleagues. The motto of Pi Alpha is Scholarship, Service, Leadership. The organization is committed to lifelong learning and participation in intellectual life. This year, we are honored to have an alumnus recipient and four students receiving this award. The alumnus recipient is Deborah S. Poole. Deborah is a 2015 graduate of our program and a PA in the Department of Psychiatry here at the University of Iowa Healthcare. Deborah made an impression on the admissions committee before we even met her. Her personal story, the road that she took, the life she experienced detailed a person of inquiry, inspection, and seeking. All the pieces that we look for in outstanding healthcare providers. Deborah could be labeled a non-traditional student, but often PA students have had various backgrounds on their way to becoming PAs. Deborah is no exception. Deborah has a bachelor's and a master's in music performance, a bachelor's in education, certification in massage therapy, and has been a yoga instructor. Deborah clearly enjoyed and excelled at the process of learning and expanding her horizons. She used these degrees first as a professional musician, playing in the Kansas City Philharmonic Orchestra, the New York City Opera Company, the American Ballet Theater Orchestra, and the National Arts Center Orchestra in Canada, just to name a few. After traveling the world with music, she moved back to her home state of Montana to continue raising her two children. During this time, she completed her certificate in massage therapy and practiced as a licensed massage therapist. Helping in her children's classrooms sparked an interest in education. She completed a bachelor's in education and went on to be the director of the gifted education programming at the Montana State Office of Public Instruction. Here she was able to advance educational theory and apply new and developing techniques to young learners. It also afforded her the opportunity to be recognized for her achievements by helping to teach in master's degree programs for teachers at international schools in Colombia and Mozambique. Yet, she felt something was missing. In her application to our program, Deborah wrote that art and medicine may seem disparate worlds, but Dr. Abraham Varghese of Stanford Medical School insists that for him, they are one. Doctors and writers are both collectors of stories, and he says his two careers have the same prerequisites: infinite curiosity about other people. This quote exemplifies Deborah in every way. Deborah has great curiosity in her world and those around her, and she makes it look effortless. She makes us all look and feel better by association. A comment from a past colleague of Deborah's summarizes her so well. She is academically gifted and among the most motivated and dedicated people I have met. That drive for success is balanced with genuine, gentle, and caring personality. I would choose her as my health care provider in a heartbeat. Deborah went on to complete a fellowship in psychiatry here at the university. Aside from her patient care, she regularly teaches in the PA program and helps in interviews and other activities of the program. Deborah makes all of her activities look easy, and we are proud to have her as an alumnus. It is because of all of the time, effort, and interest in teaching while maintaining a full clinic load that we honor Deborah with the Pi Alpha Award. Our first student recipient is Jacob Darrell Daniels. Jacob came to us from Freedley, Minnesota, near Minneapolis. Jacob attended the University of Minnesota, receiving a Bachelor's of Biomedical Engineering. In his application, Jacob described building roller coasters and developing an interest in working with the elderly. Definitely an interesting combination. He worked as a nursing assistant, primarily with Alzheimer's and dementia patients, working in settings from the hospital to home care. His quiet and steady demeanor was always a calming influence and will serve him well as a healthcare provider. Jacob excelled in all courses taken during the didactic curriculum. It is a pleasure to welcome Mr. Daniels into the Pi Alpha Society. Our second student recipient is Terry Lamont Hayes Jr. Terry grew up in St. Louis, Missouri, and made his way to Iowa State University, where he obtained a degree in kinesiology. Terry worked as a CNA in the post-anesthesia care unit here at the university and as a clinical research coordinator with the Huntington's disease patient population. Terry described his early formation for service when he would head off on Saturday mornings to help at the free medical clinic with his family. It was evident that this was a big part of who Terry is. His list of volunteering and service activities were extensive in his application, and his involvement with this type of activities continued here as a PA student. In addition to studying and getting involved in activities here, he and his wife also found time to add an energetic daughter to their life. We were lucky to have Mr. Hayes accept our invitation back in 2018, and more so to have him join our profession. I am pleased to welcome Terry into the Pi Alpha Honor Society. Our next student recipient is Nicholas Dean Jensen. Nick grew up in Muscatine, Iowa, which is along the Mississippi River, for those of you out of the state. He went on to graduate from Iowa State University with a degree in biochemistry. He is described in his letters of reference as someone that is always seeking, and it was evident in his desire to learn everything that he could. He excelled in his coursework throughout our program. Nick described his desire to be a part of a team, which was likely advanced as a soccer player while in Muscatine. He worked as a patient care technician at Mercy Medical Center in Des Moines and looked for ways to help patients in any situation they found themselves. Nick goes the extra mile to make sure that needs are met, no matter the situation. I am pleased to welcome Mr. Jensen into the Pi Alpha Society. Our final student recipient receiving the Pi Alpha Award today is Amalia Jane Lavelle. Amalia is also an Iowan, being raised in the local area. She headed out of state for college, where she was able to be part of the Bradley University cross-country team. She received a bachelor's in health science and chemistry while at Bradley, which is challenging enough without adding the extra time of the D1 sports. Her healthcare experience found her as a patient care technician in St. Luke's emergency room and in a local long-term care facility. Amalia has a passion for service and was elected as the class president. Her constant smile and can-do attitude are a positive influence on everyone around her. It is with great pleasure that I welcome Ms. Lavelle into the Pi Alpha Honor Society. It is now time for the conferring of the Master of Physician Assistant Studies degree. These candidates, having completed all of the requirements for the Certificate of Completion and Master of Physician Assistant Studies degree, and are approved by the faculty of the Carver College of Medicine for the conferring of this degree. We have pre-recorded the hooding and conferring of diplomas. Please note that the shell of the hood matches the black material of the gown and is lined with the old gold color of the University of Iowa. The velvet border of the hood is indicative of medicine, which traditionally is represented by green. Please cheer loudly at home as your graduate is called and the hood and diploma are given.
James Warner Ballard. Molly K. Bender. Catherine M. Brown. Joseph Randolph Cates. He officially becomes our 1,000th graduate of the University of Iowa PA program. Jacob Daryl Daniels. Maria Charlotte Davis Hostedler. Joseph Roger Gast. Justin Matthew Habibog. Jamie Elizabeth Hageman. Terry Lamont Hayes, Jr. Adam Michael Heinen. Lindsay Ray Jankowski. Nicholas Dean Jensen. Anjali Elizabeth Joes. Kara Joelle Kirshner. Carly Marie Kish. Alexandra Gotro Kuhn. Thank you. Sarah Klotfelter Lee. Amalia Jane Lavelle. Laura Danielle Namet. Stephanie Ann Robertus. Lena Marie Schmidt. Reed Michael Senesak. Carly Patience Wilgenbush. Miles Atlee Zahn.
So now I'm going to move to the physician assistant's oath. In 1999, the Student Academy of the American Academy of Physician Assistants developed and adopted an oath for the physician assistant profession. The oath was the product of many months of deliberation and was endorsed by the American Academy of Physician Assistants and the Association of Physician Assistant Programs. The oath states the promise to conduct oneself in accordance with the accepted guidelines for the physician assistant profession. Graduates, will you please stand wherever you are and join me in reading the physician assistant oath. Your screens will be unmuted for the reading of the oath.
If we all unmute, we got an issue.
He said don't unmute.
Oh, yeah, they're going to do it themselves.
We don't all mute?
We'll have you guys do it on mute. I'm sorry. We get a lot of feedback if everybody's on. So you'll hear me, but we would like to see you reading the oath. All right. I pledge before my family, mentors, and peers to keep, to the best of my ability, the following oath. I will provide health care with compassion, respect, honesty, integrity, and dedication, remembering always that my primary responsibility is to the health, safety, welfare, and dignity of all human beings. I will treat equally all persons who seek my care. I will uphold the tenets of patient autonomy, altruism, justice, and the principle of informed consent. I will hold in confidence the information shared with me in the course of practicing medicine, except where I am authorized to impart such knowledge. I will act with the guidance and supervision provided by a physician in a partnership dedicated to the patient's best interest. I will be diligent in understanding both my personal capabilities and my limitations, striving always to improve my practice of medicine. I will show respect for all those with whom I work and be ready to share my knowledge by teaching others what I know. I will use my training and professional standing to enhance community values and improve the community in which I work. I will actively seek to expand my intellectual knowledge and skills, keeping abreast of advances in medical art and sciences. These duties are pledged with my sincerity and on my honor. Thank you. Colleagues, friends, and family, allow me the pleasure of officially presenting to you the class of 2020 from the University of Iowa PA program. These individuals are among the brightest, most talented, and compassionate physician assistants in the country. Our state and our nation are fortunate to receive you as their future healthcare providers. Today, it is an honor for me to welcome you into the profession as colleagues. To end today's ceremony, the class of 2020 has created a presentation to share with you and to thank their families and friends. Please stay on to watch this video.